What's up, YouTube? Okay, so we are back in the car. Not only is this, I guess, where I get the most privacy, where I could just, like, talk loudly, but also just the sound is the best. I have a book or a notebook of things that I was just thinking about the other day and today. College-related stuff, because I know a lot of you guys like my, or from the views and the insights I could observe that a lot of you like the college and post-grad related content. Being somebody that has been post-grad for about 2 years now. So I'll just give some background since we're here. So I graduated from San Francisco State University as a BECA major. BECA stands for Broadcast and Electronic Communication Arts, but just a fancy word for like film videography. But it was a more broad and very encompassing major, so it wasn't a strictly like film and videography. It kind of went into a lot of different realms, the communications aspect of it. So we learned a lot about different things when it comes to just media in general, entertainment. There is like the management side of it, the audio side of it, the aesthetic side of it. Yeah, SFSU is a good school for that. A good place to be learning about that as well, just in the and its geography and its history. I want to learn more about SFSU, why I chose that school, my experiences and stuff like that. I will link the videos of me talking more in depth about it below. Today, what I wanted to talk about was to give you guys a little bit of tips for how I graduated early. Or earlier, not very early. I graduated a semester early. I'm gonna just be honest with you, like, college, from my experience of it, first of all, I want to put out there that I don't think college is for everybody. It's not a necessity to live a wonderful and fulfilling life. It is not the end all be all, but I do value it, and I do think that it can be very essential for different career fields. If you're going to go into certain fields, like, it's just something that you're going to have to do. You're going to have to get other certificates, degrees, stuff like that. It's not a bad thing. That's a good thing, because I would want somebody to have extensive like research and background in, like, when it comes to the medical field or law or engineering. Like, I would want somebody to be very well versed in that if they're going to be dealing with that. Taxes, like anything when it comes to that, like, I would want somebody to be very knowledgeable about that type of stuff. I'm just basically saying that there are certain ways to do things that doesn't involve a traditional route. I'm sure we all have known that by now, and the way our day and age is, and, you know, everybody's thing today is they want to be their own boss. They want to be a boss babe. You want to be your entrepreneur. You want to run your own business. And I'm not even saying that that is the right route to go, or that's something that you should aspire and strive to do. I don't think that route is for everybody as well. Like, I don't think you live a better life by being an entrepreneur and running your own business. And I don't think you live a better life by working a 9-to-5 and doing a traditional job. Like, it's different strokes for different folks. Bottom line, we need all those different types of strokes and all those different types of folks to keep this world going, quite frankly. Yeah, I'm just throwing that out there. Wow, I said I wasn't gonna do long intros, but here I am talking. I'm not trying to keep this intro going too long, but what I was getting at was that I feel like sometimes college is just designed to keep you there as long as possible, to keep you paying and get your money for as long as possible. And so they try to, the way it's designed, they try to drag out the process and make it as difficult for you as they possibly can. Like, nothing is just simple and easy when it comes to getting anything done. Admissions process to the graduation process, and they will do, or it just, at least that's what it feels like, and that's what it felt like for me, was that they do everything in their power to keep you there as long as you can, because there's so many different things that pops up and so many expenses, and it's just like, you just be like, come on, like, do y'all want me to graduate or not? Like, do y'all really want me to graduate? Because It's not seeming like it by the way everything is going right now. Classes being full, and then you need this, you need that. And oh, right when you think you're about to graduate, oh, you still have to do that. You know what? That's another rant for another day and another video. To business. So now we're going to get into the tips, the points of how I was able to graduate a semester early. Graduated in like December technically, and then walked the stage in May. Anyways, okay, so the first thing that really was helpful, most four-year universities, I can't speak for every single college in this video, this is just coming from my own experience, but most four-year colleges are going to recommend for you to take around 12 units per semester. But what I did was take at least 15 units per semester, units, credits, whatever you want to call them. What that did was give me a little bit of an upper hand and give me some flexibility for if I didn't pass the class, like I would still be on track. If something came up and I couldn't get a class, like I would still be on track. When I say on track, I just mean to graduate in 4 years. I did not know that I was going to be graduating a semester early until later on in my college career when I realized like, oh snap, like I could actually be out of this G thing pretty soon. And so I was just like, you know what, I'm gonna make it my goal to be out of this thing as soon as possible, because oh man, I was over it. Like I had a great, you know, overall college experience and I don't regret it at all, but your girl was like, let's get this done, let's get this show on the road, because I'm tired. Yeah, so I took at least 15 units every semester. If I could take a little bit more, because like some would have like labs, that would be one unit or two units or whatever. So sometimes it would be a little bit more. Like I remember my sophomore year, I think I was just cramming it on. Like I think at one point I was at like 18 units, 18 or 19 for one or two semesters. I do not recommend doing this if you are somebody that has like a really heavy workload or outside of school, just busy life that is going to require a lot of your attention. If you know you're going to get overwhelmed by all these classes, or if you're just in general taking classes that you know are going to be kind of tougher, you know you might have to give more attention to and that you normally would struggle with, whether this be like a math class or something big for your major that you know you're going to be taking, it's going to take a lot of your time. I would not suggest pairing all those tough classes together and adding on this much of a workload. But yeah, if you can do this, then do it. If not, really don't trip about it. Just be strategic with, like I said, the types of classes that you're taking that semester, and try to pair maybe some like one or two more difficult classes with some elective classes that you know are not going to be as hard. The bottom line, 12 units per semester might not get you there in 4 years, to be honest. You might be there like 4.5 from what I see in a lot of my peers. So I would just recommend personally 15 if you can. Remember, you do want to, at the end of the day, pass these classes. So if it's not going to work out for you, if this is going to be too much, don't do it, but just give it a try. The next thing I did was I stayed organized. I've always been somebody that used my planner that was given to me throughout all of my education years. Like we used to get free planners in like elementary through high school. So I'm not really talking so much on the planner aspect of staying organized, but what I am talking about is staying organized by getting yourself like an outline from your advisor or from your department, your major department, that is going to outline exactly what courses that you need to graduate. For SFSU in the BECA department, it was the orange paper. Like if you heard orange paper, or if you go there right now and you're in the BECA department, you know exactly what the orange paper is. That was like the Bible. Like that really got me through everything. Because what it was literally like a breakdown of all of the courses and prereqs, the GEs, the everything you needed to be able to graduate in that department. And in addition to that, the school itself also online, there's like a breakdown. There's requirements for the school itself, like for the university. And then there's requirements from your major department. So you need both, and they intertwine sometimes, but you need both to be able to finish and graduate. Hopefully that wasn't too confusing the way I explained it, but to really keep it in simple terms, just use whatever outline that they give you, even if you have to make your own Excel sheet, but keep like literally a sheet, whether it's digital or like a paper sheet, of every single thing that you need in order to graduate. And then every year when you're choosing your classes, or at the end of the semester, once you are going through all the classes that you already took, just check off all the ones that you've taken, and that way you could plan accordingly for what you need in the upcoming semester. Dude, I forgot to write this down, but I was just thinking about it. Also on the topic of like picking classes, I know that they will give you your dates, like your enrollment, your open enrollment time. Always try to get exactly what you need in the early enrollment, because I know they give like priority in early enrollment to certain groups based off of however they do it, your grade level, your last name, your department, whatever the case may be. Always try to do that, your early enrollment, and get everything you can in that time while you can, because once you get to the regular enrollment where everything is open to everybody at the same time, most of the classes are going to already be full. It's been such a long time since I've like had to think about the specifics of this stuff. So if I'm explaining it really weird, I'm sorry. I'm a bit rusty, but you get the gist of it. And keeping your sheet is going to help you know exactly what you need to take when it comes time for that early enrollment. So that's why this is so crucial. I think it's something that really kept me on track, and it's something that helped me realize when I was coming to like my junior year, I would say, that I was like, oh snap, yeah, I'm gonna be able to graduate earlier because I already have so much of this and I only need this. Technically, I really could have graduated that junior year, but I would have had to cram, and I was just like, nah, it's not worth it. I know, it's just, let me just ease into this. Let me just take my time with this and not try to just cram it all in.
Real quick. Okay, I forgot something I noticed as I was editing this video, so I just wanted to throw it in here. Also, it does help a lot because I kept saying that I already had so many requirements, and that is from taking AP courses or honor courses. I think mainly AP courses. But a lot of those courses that you take in high school are going to help you so you don't have to take them in college, and you can save yourself a lot of time and a lot of money. So I did want to just point that out, because that is something that I forgot to mention in here. That is something that is going to give you an upper hand. I don't even know how I forgot to mention that, because it is something that definitely gives you a head start, because in your first 2 years, you are going to be just only pretty much taking general education courses, and it's going to feel almost like high school all over again, in terms of like the English and math and writing and science type of classes. But by me already walking into there, having taken those AP courses in English and math, like I didn't even have to worry about that part. So that does help a lot. So if you are in high school still, definitely take AP courses or honors courses that may satisfy some college requirements, and I think that is going to definitely give you a head start.
Another thing I want to say is that it's completely okay to double major, or to major and minor, or to switch majors completely, but I think that the earlier in your couple of years, the better when it comes to you wanting to graduate on time. Or when I say on time, I just mean in 4 years. There's no real on time when it comes to college. Like, you could be there for however long you want. I would just say the earlier the better when it comes to doing that, because the longer that you put off changing majors or doing a minor or whatever it may be, the longer it's going to take to get to graduation, because there's going to be classes that you're going to have to add on, or there might be things that you took that just don't apply anymore. I got lucky with this one because I was really satisfied with my major, and I didn't feel the need to ever really change it. So I don't have as much experience with like switching majors and that whole process, or doing a minor, but I do know people that have done like minors or double majored, and they weren't that far off from graduating on time per se, like within 4 years, they probably just graduated like a semester later or a year later. But yeah, just one thing to consider, like you're probably not going to graduate, or like I'm not saying it's impossible, but you're probably not going to graduate early if you switch majors later down the line, or if you double major or add a minor very last minute. So yeah, just something to think about, but don't let that stop you from double majoring or minoring or switching. Like, don't feel like, dang, I already am on my junior year and I really hate this major. Like, I don't think this is what I want to do. If you're in that position, like, who cares if it takes you 5 years to graduate? Like, I would rather you do that and switch no matter what stage that you're in, so that it's actually something you're passionate about, than just stay and feel stuck and like locked into that just because you're already so far down. All right, so this last tip is like really the major key. Like, it's really like, if there was one thing that really helped me, it's probably this one. All of these tips were helpful, but this one low key was kind of what actually got me there. And that is to take summer classes or winter classes. I'm not sure how it works for if you're in the quarter system. I've only experienced the semester system, but I'm telling you, summer classes and winter classes, if you can afford to take it, I would highly suggest it. If you failed a class, or if you couldn't get a class because it was too full for a semester, or just couldn't fit it in your schedule, this is what really comes in clutch. It'll keep you still on that track for the classes and stuff that you weren't able to get during the regular school year. So if you can, if they're available to you and if they're feasible to you, then I would really highly suggest taking a summer class or a winter class. Because it is a shorter period of time, know that the pacing is going to be a little bit quicker. But if you're somebody that is determined and you know exactly why you're doing this and why this is necessary, then you're going to figure it out and you're going to get it done. And for me, honestly, when I took my summer and winter classes, they were all online. So I found it actually a little bit easier and just a little bit more manageable to do, because I was still able to have like my summer and have like my winter break and not have to worry about going in person. I mean, right now everything is online. There's nothing really in person. So that's, I guess, a plus. So in total, if I'm recalling correctly, I took about 3 classes that were not during the regular school year, during summer and winter. And my winter class was because I failed a class my freshman year. So I took that one. It was a history class, and it was so much easier, so much faster to get done. Like, it was just straightforward, straight to the point. So that was my winter class. And then my other summer classes that I took were just because I knew it would just get the general education requirements out the way, so that when it comes time to do my major courses and the stuff that I actually cared about and that mattered to me for why I was going to school, that would be done in person during, you know, the school year, and I was able to get those classes. This is a good way to get around like your GE courses, to get them knocked out the way, so that once you are back in regular session, that you could just focus on the stuff that matters. Obviously, if you have a busy like winter break and you have like a bunch of trips planned and stuff like that that you feel like is going to interfere with you being able to even pass the class, then like, it's just going to be a waste of time, so don't even do it. But if you can, if you know you're not going to be doing anything else really during those times off, then you might as well take advantage of it. Like, for me, I was still living in San Francisco. I was just working like every day, like just at my regular restaurant job. I felt like, I'm already going to be here, I'm just going to be working every day, I might as well just take classes while I'm at it and get this stuff knocked out. That's just another big one that I really suggest. Like I said, if it's financially like feasible for you, then great, because I know college is expensive. Yeah, it could be a lot in general. So bottom line is just not to overwhelm yourself. Everything is gonna happen in the right timing. Like, there's no race when it comes to your education and when it comes to college. Like, it's not a race. Don't take this video as like feeling pressured to graduate early, because what good is graduating early if you don't have something lined up, or if you are just doing it just to do it? Like, what good is it if you're just gonna rush through the process and not really take in anything and not retain any information? Just don't rush the process. But if you can, these are just some things that you could implement. I don't think graduating early necessarily gave me some significant advantage to the job market or to me doing what I'm already doing. Wouldn't have made that much of a difference. But like I said, it was just my preference. It was just something that I wanted to do because I was just over it, quite frankly, and I was just ready to be done. But during my time there, and like I said, it was only a semester early that I graduated, but during my time there, I do feel like I took it in and I retained all the information. And not only that, but after I finished, even to this present day, like, I am constantly still having myself learn and still educating myself when it comes to my craft and things that I do, whether it's through like online courses or YouTube. There's so many like free resources out there today that you should really be taking advantage of, even while you're in college, but also while you are out. Because like I said in plenty of my other videos, just because, you know, college ended or whatever, like, it doesn't mean that education just stops. Like, you're constantly going to be growing and learning. Who knows, you might even want to make a complete career change down the line, and that's totally fine too. So anyways, I hope this video found you guys well. I hope it still applies, even though everything is pretty much online still for most places, but just figured that it might be helpful to give you guys some tips. These could be tips that just are in general for you to just graduate on time. They don't even have to be for you to graduate early, but a lot of times when I do tell people that I was able to graduate early while working and doing a bunch of other stuff outside of it and stuff like that, they are pleasantly like curious. Camera died as usual. But yeah, I'm just gonna wrap it up. Don't feel pressured to graduate early. Don't feel pressured to even graduate in 4 years. Everything is gonna come to you in your timing. You are on your road, your journey. So don't feel the pressure because everybody else is graduating at a certain time, or everybody else is doing this and doing that. Just stay in your lane and taking it, you know, semester by semester. Focus on getting through this semester first, and then you can worry about whatever's to come later. Yeah, anyways, I wish you guys the best. I wish you guys all the prosperity this semester and these upcoming years. This is your first year in college and everything is so different. You know, I feel for you, but I know you guys are all gonna do great. I really don't know. I always realize how much I forgot to say once I'm editing. And then I'm like, am I gonna actually re-record? Probably not. So if I forget anything, I will leave it in the description, or I'll put it some text overlay or something like that. Yeah, that just about does it. Let me know if you have any questions. Leave them in the comments. If you want to learn more about SFSU and Becca and stuff like that, I do have other videos more specifically on that, as I've mentioned. So check those out. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.